Hi, it's Melita Pinto welcoming you to the weekend episode of Daiji Global Pan Vision.
Today's episode is sponsored by Apurva Associates Mangalore.
First, the headlines from abroad. UAE buns host colorful family meet. Young talents Dr. Barbosa rule the stage at KidCamp 2008. Superlative Emirates Paradella Musical Spectacular has audience asking for more in Dubai. Local headlines. Violence-stricken Kasargod limps back to normalcy, bund continues. Mangalore students answer CET exams. And in our entertainment program, we have the Bijay Group performing during Konkani Nirantari. The news in detail. UAE Buns, one of the oldest community forums in the Gulf, hosted its 34th family meet at Marriott Hotel, Dubai on Friday, April 18, 2008. The family get-together witnessed a foray of colourful cultural items, vibrant dances spiced up with the memorable events like glitzy made for each other, respectful sanmana, well-directed Tulu play and humorous Tulu skit. UAE Buns, one of the oldest community forums in the Gulf, hosted its 34th family meet at Marriott Hotel, Dubai on Friday, 18th April 2008. The family get-together witnessed a foray of colourful cultural items, vibrant dances spiced up with memorable events like glitzy made for each other, respectful sanmana, well-directed Tulu play and a humorous Tulu skit. For the last 33 years, the UAE Buns have been successfully presenting family get-togethers every year with the motive to develop a bond of fellowship and comradeship among the members of the community. The function started off with a prayer song and dance by Manjula Ganesh Rai and group, followed by the inauguration of the event by Dr. B.R. Shetty, S.B. Shetty, followed by the welcome note by representative of the organizing committee, Chandrahar Shetty. Recipient of Rajyotsava Award 2007. Shekhar Babu Shetty, a popular businessman, philanthropist, was honoured on this occasion in the traditional bun style. Neetu Shetty, an acclaimed maths teacher, was also recognised along with the guest of honour, Harsha and Hansraj Shetty. Made for Each Other stole the show as 18 participant couples catwalked to appreciation and applause. It was a treat to watch the senior couples walking the ramp hand in hand. Seema Shetty, Harsha, Hansraj and Shraddha Shetty were the judges. The vibrant Tulu, Kanda and Hindi, folk and filmy dances by the young buns, Anita Daya Shetty, Shakuntala Chandrahar Shetty, Chetana Satish Shetty, Lakshmi Ravi Prasad Shetty, Anita Jairam Shetty, Suman Ravishankar Alva, Rupa Praveen Shetty, Sarita Nagraj Shetty, Sujala Shetty, Lata Prasanna Shetty, Sheila Sudhir Shetty, Amrita VK Shetty, Shobha Shekhar Shetty, and Bhagya Premnath Shetty added colour, glitter and glamour to the whole programme. The five-star lunch gave a much-needed break and provided time for socialising. The second part of the event was dominated by the Tulu play Karnikatha Bhuta, directed by Mani Mohan Rai, and Tulu skit by Vishwanath Shetty, and were appreciated by the audience. Later, prizes were distributed to the children, which concluded this well-planned, well-knitted and well-organized event by Sarvottam Shetty and team of organizers.
Thank you.
Kanajar Welfare Association Kuwait, KWAK, an association of Kanajarians living in Kuwait, organized a dance competition, Kit Camp 2008, grand finale on Friday, April 18th at Masra Hawali Auditorium, Hawali. The event under the presidency of Lawrence Saldana was open to all Indians without any barrier. Kanajar Welfare Association Kuwait, KWAK, an association of Kanajarians living in Kuwait, organized a dance competition, Kit Champ 2008. Grand finale on Friday, April 18th at Masra Hawali Auditorium, Hawali. The event under the presidency of Lawrence Saldana was open to all Indians without any barrier. Of the 40-odd contestants, 5 were selected for grand finale under the junior category, 4 under classical and 2 for the senior championship. Veteran Bharatanatyam artist Dr. Francis Barboza, director Satyaradhana Arts USA, was flown in as chief guest for the grand finale. The program began with a welcome dance by Vijay Barboza, followed by lighting of the lamp by President Lawrence Saldana and the judges of the event, Dr. Francis Barboza, Sister Mary Darshini of Carmel School, Lekha Ramachandran of Indian Central School and Nupur Sharma of Gulf Indian School. Extracurricular and academic awards were presented to the members' children by Father Melvin Dikuna. Lawrence Saldana and Father Melvin Dikuna provided information on the association and the contest. Veteran Bharatanatyam artist Dr. Francis Barboza was felicitated with a shawl, memento and fruits by Father Melvin Dikuna. He was also honored with the title Nritya Samrat. Dr. Francis Barboza expressed his feelings of gratitude and happiness after the felicitation. The audience was entertained by Dylan Narona, Glenn Saldana and Rhea Pereira with their melodious songs. Superb dances were presented by Nach Balie and the ballerines. The final round of competitions were held for classical championships, junior champions and senior champions. As expected, performance by Dr. Francis Barboza was a first and memorable experience for the Kuwait audience. Awards and medals were distributed to the finalists and winners by Dr. Francis Barboza. Rose Mendonca then delivered the vote of thanks. Following were the winners of the competition: classical champion Tejashwini, junior champion Robita D'Souza, senior champion Melissa Fernandez. All the finalists were honored with medals by Dr. Francis Barboza. The music was provided by the rock band Deep Impact with up-and-coming singing sensation Glenn Saldana. And the program was compared by one of Kuwait's leading MC, Lloyd. Emirates Paradella, one of the premier organizations in the UAE, have always come up with something unusual, and this year it was no different. Emirates Paradella Musical Spectacular, organized on Friday, April 18th indeed, was an enthralling event for the audience. Year after year, Emirates Paradella has always come up with something unusual, and this year it was no different. For that matter, this year the enthusiastic Paradella group found a lovely though odd venue to showcase their event in fine style. The attractions on stage were many, just like the distractions off the stage too. Many were dressed to kill, while others found the setting much to their liking. As the event began to unfold, compeers Jonathan and Melita started promptly and promisingly too. When the skies above closed for the day, it was time to rock the place with Goa's Sky High, who, as is their wont, started making waves all over the place with their solid, mind-boggling style. The fire in this band is to be seen, to be believed, and their energy is spellbinding. However, one must say that the band found it hard to get going in their first session and played all over the place with no fixed music in place. It was only in the second place that they found their rhythm after establishing the pulse of the crowd. From here on, there was no stopping. Sky High as they belted popular numbers in more than one language, much to the delight of the crowded dance floor. Next on stage were the high-sounding singers from the reality world, Irfan and Sumitra Iyer, who outshone each other while keeping up the harmony on the singing front. For both the singers, this was an opportunity to impress their followers who have watched them on TV. Sumitra shone with her peppy numbers while Irfan settled for the mellow mood and also sang a few duets. As the evening wore on, with some fine and pleasantly cool wind blowing, there was a lovely picnic-like atmosphere prompting everyone to have a go on the dance floor. With plenty of music to offer, everyone was catered to with a variety of numbers in almost all languages. The beautiful Nadia, although seemingly bulging at the wrong places, made the crowd yell as she belly danced to glory for three beautiful Arabic numbers. However, all the cheers were reserved for the romantic Latino dancers who excelled not only with their fine movements but also some fantastic costumes. Brazil, Spain and France were all rolled into one in Dubai, and there was more than tango alone as the Latino dancers thrilled the onlookers with some classy acts. With a galaxy of prizes and a host of dignitaries gracing the occasion, the cause of the Emirates Paradella group was well served. With such a mammoth venue, the organizers must have planned and executed everything with great planning. Hats off to Emirates Paradella, who delivered what they promised. Being an evening event unlike their earlier programs, and a new and unknown venue at that, the end result was satisfying. The entertainment dished out was worth the cause with such a fine star cast, which augurs well as they plan more such events in the future. We still have the local news for you, but on the other side of the short commercial break. Inland Builders have been a pioneer in the creation of ultra-modern residential and commercial development in Mangalore and Bangalore. With ongoing projects in Mangalore like Inland Ornate, Inland Avenue, Inland Eminence, Inland Evoke, Premium Luxury Apartments, Kankanadi, Mangalore. And in Bangalore, Inland Everglades, Inland Ilanza. Shortly, Inland Builders are launching Mangalore's first international standard apartment complex at Mary Hill Airport Road, Mangalore, known as Inland Windsors. A modern grand structure of 23 floors, 230 super luxury apartments with facilities like garbage chute, multi-purpose hall with shuttle and squash court, supermarket, jogging track, table tennis, gym, swimming pool, TV room, etc. Bookings open. Inland Builders, Mangalore, 4 2 4 9 6 11 0. Welcome back. Kasaragod, the border district of Kerala, which is only a few kilometers away from Mangalore, has always been hitting news headlines owing to political reasons. But these days, it has been on news for communal reasons. The town went on a violent spree with a spate of 4 murders in 5 days. Though the situation is limping back to normalcy, tension still prevails in the area. We have an exclusive report on this. The entire district is observing Bandh following spate of murders. Police security has been tightened. Meanwhile, the body of local BMS leader and advocate Suhas, who was murdered on Thursday evening, was brought to the city from Mangalore accompanied by heavy security. Police have deployed additional forces on every major point, and as of now, only police are seen in and around the city. Civilians are virtually confined to their homes, while schools and colleges have been declared holiday. The city for long has a bloody history, but so far it was known for rivalry between political parties, which usually ended in a bloodbath. But now suddenly the bloodthirsty city seems to have found another reason to bathe in blood. While the spate of murders has continued unabated, the motive behind these murders has changed from party rivalry to rivalry between two communities. Even after 3 murders in the first 4 days of the week, the city now still seems thirsty for human blood. While certain Sandeep was murdered at the beginning of the week, Mohammed Sinan was murdered to avenge former's death on Wednesday evening. Even before the people could come in terms with those two ghastly murders, locally popular advocate and BMS leader Suhas was stabbed to death, possibly to avenge Sinan's murder. Between this, almost 4 persons of different communities were stabbed. The city has fully been cordoned off by police and no one's allowed either to enter and come out of the city. The otherwise busy city is wearing a deserted look with no business activities. Even bus service between the city and Mangalore remains suspended as of now. Kasaragod has been observing Bandh for the last 2 days. 4 innocent persons have laid down their lives for no fault of theirs. Isn't it right then that religion is the opium of society? These are testing times for students. While SSLC and PUC students have completed their exams, degree students have just begun theirs. Meanwhile, it is also time for competitive exams. Students all over the state answered CET exams on Saturday, April 19th. Common Entrance Test or CET for Engineering, Medical and Dental Admission was held across Karnataka on Saturday, April 19th. This is the first CET exam after CET unit was converted into Karnataka Examination Authority or KAE. The authority has appointed almost 8,000 staff for the smooth running of the entire process. Even students from border and other states are answering exams. This year, a total of 4,500 outstation students are writing exams in Karnataka. The key answers will be webcasted in KEA's website on Thursday, April 24th. Now it's time for us to take another break. When we come back, we will begin our entertainment program, so stay tuned.
ಬಜೆಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ಎಸ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಗೆ ಟ್ಯಾಲಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಮನೆ ನಿರ್ಮಾಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಸುದೀರ್ಘ ಅನುಭವವಿರುವ ಅಪೂರ್ವ ಸಮರ್ಪಿಸುತ್ತಿದೆ ಅತ್ಯಾಧುನಿಕ ಅತ್ಯಪೂರ್ವ ಹಾಗೂ ಸುಸಜ್ಜಿತ ಫ್ಲಾಟ್ಗಳು.
ನಗರದಾದ್ಯಂತ ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧಿಯನ್ನು ಪಡೆದು ಮುನ್ನುಗ್ಗುತ್ತಿರುವ ಅಪೂರ್ವ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನದಿಂಗಿತವನ್ನು ನೀಡುತ್ತದೆ.
ತಕ್ಷಣ ಸಂಪರ್ಕಿಸಿ ಅಪೂರ್ವ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್, ಅಶೀಶ್ ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಕೊಡಿಯಾಲ್ಗುತ್ತು ಈಸ್ಟ್, ಕೊಡಿಯಾಲ್ ಬೈಲ್, ಮಂಗಳೂರು. 4249-2417.
ಜಾಗ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಆ ದೋಷ ಈ ದೋಷ, ಮನೆ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಒಂದಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ. ಫ್ಲಾಟ್ ಅಂತೂ ಮೇಲೇಳುವ ಮೊದಲೇ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬುಕ್ಕಿಂಗ್.
ಸ್ವಾಮಿ, ಹೊಸ ಮನೆಯ ಯೋಗ್ಯತೆ ಎಂದು ತಿಳಿಸ್ತೀರಾ?
ಅಪ್ಪ ರಾಮಪ್ಪ, ಅಣ್ಣವರ ಸರ್ವ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗೆ ಪರಿಹಾರ ನೀಡಪ್ಪ, ಬಾರ್ಲಾ?
ಮೂಲಭೂತ ಸೌಕರ್ಯ ಇರುವಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಸಜ್ಜಿತ ಫ್ಲಾಟ್ಗಳ ಖರೀದಿ ಬಾಡಿಗೆಗಾಗಿ ಪಡೆಯಲು ನಮ್ಮ ಸೇವೆ ಸದಾ ಸಿದ್ಧ.
ಫಾರ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ಎಸ್ಟೇಟ್, ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ರಿಯಲ್ ಎಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪರ್ಸ್, ಮ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್.